I was convinced that my brother Ted could not take a bad photograph. So I tried the following experiment.
Hey, Ted!
And here were the results. Me, on the other hand, my pictures were consistently so bad that my parents stopped framing them.
Oliver, come out. Let's see your suit.
Charlotte, the lights.
What about them?
The sun's still out. Why do you need them on?
Well, I can't see in the dark. Turn that back on.
Who said that? I can't see you. Come to the sound of my voice.
Ah. Do I have to take a picture?
Yes, at least one. All our relatives think you're dead.
I can't move. Well, obviously, you need a new suit.
Oh, come on. That one's fine.
Oh, Jerry, look at the sleeves.
Oh, now she can see.
Jerry, it's picture day. It's a moment in time that will last forever.
Oh, God, I hope not.
Just put him in Ted's suit. Oh,
he's so much smaller than Ted.
Why don't I just stay home?
You're going, and this afternoon we're taking you to buy a new suit.
Uh-oh. I knew where this was heading.
It's 100% porcupine.
Oh, it's absolutely darling. We'll take it.
Wait a minute. You know what? I want to choose my own suit.
No.
Maybe the reason I take such lousy pictures is because I have no control over what I wear. I'm 12 years old. I don't need my mom to pick out my clothes.
Oliver, I'm 42. Your mom still picks out my clothes.
Yeah, and you hate that shirt.
I do hate this shirt. Why do you make me wear this shirt?
You love that shirt.
Stop controlling me. Here. Go after school today. Get whatever you want.
Blue. No pinstripes. And no pleats. They make it look hippie.
Meanwhile, my brother Ted was having a picture-perfect afternoon at baseball practice.
Attaboy, Teddy. Great stag.
Thanks, coach.
Why don't you come on in and bat? Okay, left field. Here it comes. Whoops. Too many Wheaties.
Wow. An accidental homer.
Ted couldn't have worshipped or admired his coach more. Not unless he happened to look like this.
Oh, hi, Ted.
Hi, Elke. What are you doing here?
Oh, I was just running. That is why I am so hot and sweaty and naked.
She didn't actually say naked. That's just how he heard it.
Hey, Elke, if you stick around for a minute, you can see me hit.
Oh, that would be nice. I'm naked.
All right, Teddy, you ready to bat? Hey, coach, I'd like you to meet my friend, Elke.
How do you do? Did you know your friend Ted here is the best player on the field?
Second best. Coach here would have went pro if he didn't hurt his knee.
Oh.
Well, it was a pleasure meeting you, Elke. Come on, Ted, you're up. She's cute. Now you better hit a homer.
The dreaded picture day was right around the corner.
I refuse to take picture day so seriously. Tomorrow, I'm gonna sneer or make a funny face.
Oliver, I know picture day season is stressful, but there's only 16 hours to go.
Oh my God, there's only 16 hours to go.
Not nearly enough time for tweezing and plucking, waxing and pimple popping.
16 hours.
He is so much better than last year.
It was only a practice, but with his dream girl watching, Ted felt pressure like it was the seventh game of the World Series.
Left field.
Home run, deep to left field, exactly as promised. Everyone went wild. Well, almost everyone.
Hey, Ted, picture for the school paper.
Ted finally took a bad picture, and I was determined to finally take a good one.
Excuse me?
Yes?
I need a suit for picture day.
Oh, very nice. What kind of suit would you like?
I want a suit that sticks to the man. One that says, stop taking yourself so seriously. See, picture day doesn't capture anyone's personality. I want a suit that says Oliver Beene is here, and he's gonna break some rules.
I got just the thing.
It was no use. It was a force too great to overcome, and I never felt so powerless. Until... Ha-ha! Now this was a suit!
This is gonna be the best picture day ever! Nervous?
Nah, I used to hate school photo day, but I guess it does prepare us for a lifetime of being judged by our looks. Ooh, nice suit.
Pierre Cardin, Ferragamo, Evan Picone, and Yves Saint Laurent. Ooh, watch where you step, I dropped a few names.
Our principal Schreiner lived for school photo day.
Remember, our school might not have the highest test scores or the prettiest cheerleaders, but I'll be darned if we're not going to take the greatest yearbook photos of all time. Beene, remember, we're only as strong as our weakest link.
He's going to pay for those words.
What do you mean?
I'm taking my school photo in a superhero costume. Yeah, tights, cape, hood, the whole shebang.
Oliver, I like tights and capes as much as the next guy, but why now? Why picture day?
I'm turning the whole system on its ear. I'm being controversial, challenging people's perceptions of how society works. It's conceptual. It's comedy is life.
You did great.
Hey, Ansel Adams, what's taking so long?
Well, with each kid, I have to make sure that the light reflects...
I don't want excuses! I want good pictures.
Next.
Remember this moment, kids. Not this moment. The moment coming up, the one after this. Hello?
Elke, what are you doing here?
Oh, I was just returning your coach's jacket. It got a little cold last night, so he let me wear it.
Last night?
He took me to a drive-in, and it got a little chilly being topless.
What?
He has one of those, how do you say, convertibles.
So, last night, you went on a date with my coach?
He is an amazing man. We are going out again tonight.
That's terrific. Have fun.
Thanks, Ted. Bye-bye.
You spineless sniveling worm, Ted.
What were you doing back there?
Lurking.
You just gonna let your coach get away with this?
What can I do? Well, how far are you willing to go?
With her? Oh, all the way, totally.
No, Ted. Ted, stay with me, okay? How far are you willing to go to hurt him?
Hurt coach?
Oh, yeah.
He's the best. I can't do that.
Ah, you got a conscience. That's okay. I can help you with that. See, Ted, your coach betrayed you, so he's got to be punished.
Okay. I'm in.
The following
name?
Oliver Beene.
Beene? Are you Ted's brother?
Yeah.
Oh, wow, that kid takes one heck of a picture. In fact, I got a blow-up of him in my storefront. Gets me all kinds of work. Kid just pops on the screen. And I tell you what, I've used every backdrop imaginable. His flesh tone just seems to match it like a chameleon. I mean, just a wonderful kid. So photogenic. All right, this will be pretty quick and painless. Okay. What do you say we get this show on the holy smoking mother of God?
What? Please, just hurry up and take the picture.
Kid, if I take this picture and Principal Schreiner sees it, he'll have a heart attack. I'll do it. Okay, smile.
Oh, nice, nice. Work it, work it. Pull back a bit, not too much. There you go. Good, good. There you go. Show me those muscles. Get mean, not that mean, not that mean. Very nice.
How long does Beene need to take a terrible picture? Beene, you think that's funny, don't you?
Man, my brother's a freak.
That's right.
Hello? Yes, this is Elke. I'm afraid I have some bad news. I don't like you. I never want to see you again. I must cancel our date. Goodbye forever.
Okay, done. What do we do now?
Now we buy a gun.
What?
You know, sorry, that's a plan I got going with somebody else. You and I just hang out in your lobby and wait.
All right.
All right. Explain.
Come on, what's the big deal? What's your sense of humor?
Enough! Look, do you know what an egregious violation of the dress code this is?
Au contraire. My shirt's tucked in. I'm wearing a belt. And I'm not wearing sneakers. I made sure that this suit is entirely within the bounds of the current dress code. You've got nothing on me.
Ha! Who is powerless now? There was nothing my arch enemy could do. All right, he could do that.
Dr. Beene, Mrs. Beene, this latest escapade of your son's warrants suspension.
I mean, that's a little extreme, isn't it? I mean, all he did was wear a little superhero costume.
On picture day? All other days slip through the sieve of time, but picture day is the one day that is immortalized in the annals of history. Picture day is the only day that matters. Oliver must go!
Okay. Look, there must be some other way.
I might reconsider suspension if you take Oliver to see this gentleman.
No.
No. No. It hasn't come to this yet. He's only a child.
What? What is it?
Son, you know how a dentist is a doctor for the teeth? Well, tomorrow, Principal Schreiner wants us to go visit a brain dentist.
I'm seeing a shriek!
Somehow, Coach Wright actually bought Ted's Elke impersonation and assumed the date was off.
All right. All you gotta do is swoop in to comfort her, badmouth Coach a little bit, and she's yours. Now I'll give you some alone time. Come in to back you up.
Hey, Elke. Something wrong?
Oh, Ted! Coach Wright has stood up on me!
Oh. I wish I could say that surprises me.
What do you mean?
He's a horrible person. He doesn't care about women. He's got a new girl every day of the week.
Oh, but he seems so nice.
Ah, he is nice. I can't do this. He's perfect. You're perfect. You two belong together. It's my fault he didn't show. Call him and reschedule your date. Now go.
And Coach Wright is such a jerk.
Liar!
So, what brings you here today?
Well, Oliver did something at school, and the principal said it was either this or suspension.
Charlotte, don't blame yourself.
Hmm. What? Why would I blame myself?
Because it's kind of your fault.
Back to Oliver.
How do you figure that?
You established a pattern of irresponsible behavior in the house.
What are you talking about?
Oh, I don't know. You and your I need lights to see.
Oh, God, not the lamp thing.
Dr. and Mrs. Beene, I am a child psychologist, and technically you're not children, so perhaps it would be best if the two of you were...
So Oliver is acting out because I left a light switch on?
Thank you!
Can you believe that? Did you hear that? He blames me for everything. Just like my father did. And he knows how much I hate my father.
You hate Grandpa?
Oh, great. Yeah. Here come the tears. I'm the bad guy. But when you leave the lights on knowing full well it drives me crazy, it makes me feel completely ignored.
Must be very irritating.
It makes me feel like you don't love me.
Oh, how could you say that? Of course I love you. I just don't want to disappoint you all the time.
Doc, I guess I act this way because when I was a little boy, my mom wouldn't breastfeed.
Why don't we try it? A different approach, okay? I'm going to show you two an ink blot, and I'd like you to tell me what you think it means.
Oh.
Oh. Oh. You want to see Oliver alone?
Yeah. Wait a minute. Is he crazy?
He's not crazy.
Should you let the man answer? You always do that.
I don't do anything.
So?
Why do you think you're here?
Have you been in the room the last few minutes? I put on a funny costume for picture day. It was just a joke. See for yourself.
I don't get it.
Well, you're not the only one. Nobody gets it.
Well, that must be very frustrating for you.
You have no idea.
Well, tell me about it.
Comedians have this saying, he's too smart for the room. Sometimes I feel like it's me. Except I'm not even that smart.
Interesting. Why don't you tell me more?
For the next hour, that's what I did. I told him about my family, my friends, school. I told him about my dreams and my fears. I told him things I never thought I'd tell anyone. Like the week I honestly thought I was in love with Wilma Flintstone.
I don't know, maybe it's the way she walks around barefoot using that elephant vacuum cleaner. Does that make me weird?
Yes, it does. Everyone knows that Betty Rubble is the cute one. Well, we're out of time. I need to write something down as to why this little photo incident occurred.
That it was just a joke.
Bureaucrats, you know, they're going to want to hear more.
All right. Tell them I hit my head and I wasn't myself.
I don't think they're going to buy that.
Fine, then just tell them that if I was going to look like a freak and everyone was going to make fun of me anyway, I might as well do it on my terms.
Why would you look like a freak?
Because I always do. I'm not tall, I'm not handsome, I'm not fast, I'm not strong, I'm not...
You're not Superman.
Exactly. And that's why it's funny.
Mm-hmm. And now I get it. And it is funny.
Finally.
Let me tell you something interesting about being 12. It stinks. I mean, you're not a kid, you're not an adult. You're just stuck in the middle. And you specifically have a big problem. You are very bright.
So what should I do about it?
Take 2 aspirin and grow up.
Hmm.
All right, boys, let's take the field. Hey, Jeff.
Hey, Coach. How are you and Elke doing?
Well, we're halfway there.
What do you mean?
Well, tonight's our second date, which is money in the bank for me, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Not really.
I'm saying the second date is where I close the deal.
Ah, the deal. What deal?
I'm sleeping with Elke tonight, Ted. Speaking of home runs, you're up, slugger.
My brother realized then that he didn't need to lie about Coach Wright being a jerk. He really was one.
This date cannot happen tonight.
All right, here it comes.
And with that glorious shot, Ted made sure his coach wouldn't be rounding third and heading home anytime soon. And Dr. Feniger, let's just say he went to bat for me.
Dear. After analyzing Oliver Beene, I've determined that his psyche is especially fragile right now.
Beene! Beene, Oliver?
Nice move, man.
Hey, Beene, great picture.
I fear that any added stress...
That's just classic.
...would do irrevocable damage. So as not to upset him further, I advise that his photograph be printed in the yearbook as is.
Holy cow!